Working out, you don't want to fill up. So reach for the silver bullet, the one that won't slow you down.
Talking about cool, it's like it's the right beer now. Pour it on and work it out.
Spin Man!
So what are you doing, St. Augustine?
Well, I'm just kind of like spinning basketballs.
What parts of your body do you spin it?
I'll spin one on each toe, one on each shin, one on each thigh, one on my stomach, one on top of my head, one in each hand, and one right in between my legs.
That's a world record.
Yeah.
What else do you spin?
Chairs, books, skateboards, stuff like that.
Footballs?
Yeah, I can spin those too.
Fly button?
Oh, yeah.
Spin Man!
Steven Seagal. He can take a compliment.
This guy's good, Richie.
He can take an insult.
One of these days, your wise mouth is going to get the rest of your body in a whole lot of trouble.
He can even take a punch. But what this cop's really best at is taking out the garbage. Steven Seagal, Out for Justice, rated R. Starts Friday, April 12th at a theater near you. Career start at ITT Technical Institute. Call now for an informative brochure. 1-800-942-0099. It's back. Stephen King's blood-curdling tale of terror. Misery. King's most acclaimed work, and now a major motion picture. It's yours now for just $7.95 when you enter the chilling world of the Stephen King Library. Imagine an exclusive collection of horror, Pet Sematary, The Shining, Christine, the chart toppers, the books that became blockbuster movies, all in the original hardcovers at just $14.95 each, all with a cancel anytime guarantee. But if you want the terror to last, we'll send you a new volume, including King's new releases about every 7 weeks. Enjoy each for 10 days. There's never an obligation to buy. Possess misery with no risk. The Stephen King Library, where the master is coming back to haunt you.
Call 1-800-368-6000 now to get Misery. Keep it and pay just $7.95 plus shipping and handling. Future volumes will come, one every 7 weeks, each with a 10-day free trial. Keep only the ones you want. Cancel any time.
You know, there's only one more video left for tonight from the block of debut videos. That's the thing when we play the new videos. You know, finally, after Metallica released Kill 'Em All, which I think, you know, I always say my favorite bands, but I haven't said my favorite album yet, and Kill 'Em All is probably my favorite album of all time. Well, after they released that, and after they released Ride the Lightning, and after they released Master of Puppets, and after they released Garage Days Revisited EP, they made a video. Here is Metallica with the long version of One.
I cannot see.
that there's not much left in me. Nothing is real but pain now. Hold my breath as I wish for death. Oh, please, God, wake me.
That's about, whoa! You could have seen the demise right there of Ricky Rackman. Wouldn't it be great if we ended tonight's show with a really bad injury? That's about it for tonight, and what a great way to end it. Next Saturday, I'm going to announce the winner of Headbangers Ball Mission Megadeth Contest. See how accidents like that happen, but I maintain it. This is the kind of things that all this New York crew won't see around here anymore because, hold on, this is my last show ever taping in New York, and honestly, I got to thank all the people because this is where I got my television start, and my television end too. And we can tell in the year and a half that I haven't really learned that much, but all the people here have been really, really good, and I'm going to really miss them a lot, and this is really, really sad. So when you look at all the people that are on the credits, they're all really good friends, except maybe two or three of them that I'm not really sure about. But the rest of them, I've had a real lot of fun being here, and they're all really, really great people, even though they put posters of Donnie Wahlberg up when somebody did put some makeup on my face and stuff like that. But I had a lot of fun. This is really sad. This is from the last time to me ever to say this in New York, and we'll see the show in L.A. Next Saturday? Next Saturday, I'll be in L.A. And actually, you probably won't notice a difference, except my motorcycle probably be placed on the set. Once again, thank you, everybody in New York. Remember to keep one foot in the gutter, one fist in the gold, and I'll see you next week from L.A.
From your favorite artist.
Get up, get up.
What you don't see is the subliminal message. Look closely, listen carefully, seek the message.
I need some sensible shit.
MDB.
Bart!
Let me start at the start. Let's move right along. You can all sing along at the sound of the gong. Once upon a time, about a week ago, all of a sudden, trouble started to grow. Alarm was buzzing, I was snoozing, supposed to get up now, but I was refusing to let reality become an intrusion, cause in dreamy dreamland, I was cruising, but the buzz kept buzzing, my head kept buzzing, gave the radio a throw and heard an explosion. Opened up my eyes, to my surprise, there stood Homer and his temperature rise. I was chilling, he was yelling, face all distorted cause he was propelling. I said, I'm real sorry, but that didn't cut it. I started to protest, but Dad said,
shut it, get up, mow the lawn, move it on the double, cause if you don't, you're in deep, deep trouble.
Like a pig and the sun is blazing. Homer's in the driveway, getting in the car with Mom and Lisa. Hope they're going real far. And Dad yells,
Bart!
And I go, yo! He goes,
you done yet?
And I go, no. So he goes,
oh, you're too slow.
So I step on the gas, speed up the mow. Didn't see that sprinkler underneath that tree. Wham! Raining on me. I go, whoa! Homer goes,
no! Now you can't go to the boat show.
Soaked to the bone, standing in a puddle. No one needs to tell me I'm in deep, deep trouble. Looking at the sky with my sunshades on. Now I've never ever claimed that I was a smarty, but inspiration hits me. Let's have a party. Called up my posse. They were here in a flash. They brought all their pals. We started to thrash. There was dropping and stomping an occasional crash. A fist fight or two and Nintendo for cash. We raided the fridge. Dogs raided the trash. I got a little worried when the windows got smashed. The next thing you know, Mom and Dad are home. The kids disappear and I'm all alone. Everything's silent except for my moan and the low bluesy tone of a saxophone. They look at me, then they go into a huddle, get the sinking sensation I'm in deep, deep trouble. To my tale of sadness, I was dragged down the street by his royal dadness. We rounded the corner and came to a stop on the inside Jake's barber shop. I said, please, sir, just a little off the top. Dude shaved me bare, gave me a lollipop. So on my head, there's nothing but stubble. Man, I hate being in deep, deep trouble. Oh, come on.
and a Tracy Guns from LA Guns and a Richard from Shark Island. And they combined this mishmash of talent to create a band called Contraband. Now, I know that Michael, Bobby, and Cher, I guess, kind of got the idea.
Michael Schenker, Bobby Brockman.
It's hard to just drop names there.
Michael Schenker from MSG.
And former Scorpion.
Right, yeah.
And Bobby Blotzer from Rat. And Cher from Vixen.
Right.
Yep. Now, they met at MTV Unplugged, and I guess they kind of put the idea together, right?
Absolutely.
Then how did you guys get involved?
How did we get involved, man?
In the band, I mean.
Very funny, Rick. we got phone calls, man. Hey, you guys want to do this thing? And we're like, yeah, you know. It's just... kind of happened.
You know, Alan, we all have the same manager, so we're all kind of involved with the same manager. And he like mentioned it to us as a joke one time. We're like, yeah, right. We're gonna do a one-off album, you know. But after we were rehearsing at the same place, we kind of jammed one day together to a lot of old songs and stuff, and it was just kind of fun. So we just said, well, what the heck, let's just put it out. He was willing to do it, and we just said, okay, let's just do it. So
cool.
It rocks, too, man.
Yeah, it's
well, we're going to be playing a video from you guys in a little bit and coming back and talking to you. But right now, here's a video from a band called L.A.
Who?
L.A. Guns. It's I Want to Be Your Man.
Word.
Gonna